us. Oh boy, those shells look good. Can we get the kill? Yes, we can.
Oh well.
There we go. See, maybe I just need to yell at Art. There he goes. This is the ship that actually this ship is replacing. Warspike typically had the most powerful guns for Tier 6. Now it is being replaced. What's up guys? I hope you guys like that little bit of Stigmans back to get together. Welcome to the channel again, or new, welcome to the channel. This is the Tier 6 Premium Battleship, Mutsu. She is the second, and if my memory stands correctly, last Nagato-class battleship that was ever constructed by the Imperial Japanese Navy. She was built in around the end of World War I, 1923, around that time. She was modernized in 1934-36 with improvements to her armor and machinery. Rebuilt the superstructure to the Paragon kind of style, the big tower in the front. She was in participating Battle of Midway and Solomon Islands of 42. Didn't see much combat. Spent most of the time in the Pacific War training crew. She returned to Japan in early 43. That June, her aft magazine detonated while she was at anchor, sinking the ship with a loss of 1,121 crew members, if I remember correctly, and visitors. Investigation concluded it was either the work of a disgruntled crew member or something like that. Pretty much they kept it shut closed. They didn't want to tell anybody that the ship exploded because that would have been a major loss to the patriotism to the Japanese. And the explosion happened right under here. You can see it with my mouse here, I'm circling under the third turret, and the ship exploded, splitting in two, and went under. Of course, a lot of good sailors and men died from it. But enough of the past. What is it like in World of Warships? Well, it's bad. I'm sorry to say this, but it is bad. Now, there is reasons, but let's go over those stats, shall we? First off, we have survivability of 58,400. Now, let's compare that to, because there is a rival here. Let's put in only battleships, Japanese and British, because there's... And... Tier 7. Okay, there we go. I wanted to go over to Nagato, which is 6,500, and the Mutsu, which is 58, so it's not too bad. Warspite has 53, so it has more armor than the Warspite for health. Now, there's a reason why I'm going over the Warspite over this ship, not the Nagato, even though they're both cousins. I mean, look at that deck style. Very close to each other. There's a reason. The reason is because technically, with its 410mm guns, it is the most powerful Tier 6 ship in the game for guns. It has the more powerful caliber. With these, at shell velocity and everything else, its maximum damage is 1240 compared to 1140 with the Warspite. Now, shell may be powerful, but here is my problem. I don't know why, I don't know how, but look at that dispersion. 214 meters compared to Warspite at a dispersion of 204. Right at Tofuso, 224. I don't care if it's said that the Fuso's worse. This Mutsu has the worst dispersion of every single battleship I've ever had to play with. And I've been playing this thing for the past 2 days in a row, grinding the commander, that way I had a fair chance of giving you guys a chance of what this ship can do, giving it a fair chance to be a decent ship. And it cannot be. I understand the armor, because the armor isn't that great either. The armor deck to the Citadel is 305. Any tier 6 will pen this thing, and pen it badly. If I remove this deck, there's nothing blocking that Citadel very much on the front slopes at all. Maybe a little bit of 305 on the sides here, but not much. You will easily pin this structure completely. All you have to do is aim at the top deck here and dive in. The sloped Citadel decks are not good. They will get penetrated. You will get Citadeled. I've gotten Citadeled in this thing too many times to know that the armor is not that good. Now, what else does it have that maybe it has a trick up its sleeve? Well, it does have torpedoes. It has two on each side replacing the secondaries. You can see inside the ship where they are. They are 7 kilometer torp range. And surprisingly, they reload in 21 seconds. So you have a very, very fast torpedoes. Anti-air is not that good, of course. You have some singles, you have two dual 20s, dual 40s, sorry, and the dual purpose for 127s. You do have a lot of, you had 10 of these 140s as well, which actually were pretty good when I've been playing with it lately. It's got some pretty decent secondary oomph. But like I said, it's not good. It reminds me of the Warspite all too well. Great guns, terrible armor. But at least the Warspite has a decent anti-air. Doesn't this thing have anything? The torpedoes, maybe, but they're only at close range. And by that time, you've already gotten hit pretty bad. Well, Raz, there's gotta be something else you can tell me. Come on, there's gotta be something good with this ship. No, there isn't. I'm sorry to say this. I've had too much trouble with this ship. The Mutsu is definitely, I have to say, not my favorite premium. If I'm gonna pick a premium in this game, it's not gonna be that. If I'm gonna pick a premium in tier 6, I'm going to be picking my Arizona, hands down, straight down, and not even with the commander perks. I will pick it again. The gun dispersion is great, the accuracy is great, the anti-air is not great, I'll give it that, but at least it's somewhat better. But the guns are with the kicker. I can't pen an Arizona in the Mutsu. I will bounce rounds off this thing. I'll overpen because the guns are so inaccurate, they'll hit the top deck before they even hit the bomb deck. They're just that terrible. You're not going to hit anything. It's a spray and pray ship, basically. And just to prove it, I got a whole bunch of video of this thing, so let's get started with it. Okay guys, we're on Neighbors, and this match again. This is another reason why I don't like the Mutsu. We are again high tier in a tier 6 ship against tier 8 ships. Tier 8 ships can easily overpen or citadel my armor. anyway, we're going to be following the team, and we're going to be doing what I can only do best. Support role. Since this thing cannot do anything else other than that. We're of course spotted. There's got to be DD and B that's spotting my ship. It's the only logical reason. And there's a cruiser off in the distance of the map. It's an enemy Otago. He's near broadside. Let's try to take a shot. But like I said, look at that dispersion. It's god awful. Look at that. Yes, he turned, I know, but that doesn't matter. The shell dispersion is so terrible in this thing. You might as well just say, here's my ship. Come and kill it. It is definitely a very terribly inaccurate ship. Enemy Raspe, sorry. And he's turning out. We might be able to hit him with one or two. No, we're not going to hit him with any. I'm going to run my spotter. Of course I'm getting attacked. Spotter airborne. But no one's able to pin the target yet. Alright, we got enemy Kia. I aimed high. But yeah, we hit him finally. We hit a ship. And it was the typical overpin damage. And of course, wrong fire, and I just pulled a Raz. I know.
Instantly fire and heal.
How dumb are you? Alright, there's an enemy Mutsu. And we're gonna try to hit him and... Okay, 6,000. Again, over pens. And one penetrating shell. We have an enemy Leander, who's... doesn't know how to use a British cruiser, I think. But he just shot pretty good for what he's doing. And I'm gonna pull a different type of Raz. The beaching type. We have an enemy North Carolina who's beached himself too, so we're not the only ones doing it. So I'm firing at him because he's broadside. And we hardly do any damage to him. Enemy destroyer has smoked him. So now he can't be seen, but I can be seen. Alright, we backed up enough. Problem solved, sir. I'm gutting up the engine. Now we're going back forward again. And we're going to go around this island, and then I'm going to push up. We need to push. Can get them to hit the... There we go. We lost all the caps now. now we're going in. I'm going to have our team focus that Akatsuki. Hopefully they get the picture. Yep, Pensacola is firing at him. And of course he'll do massive damage since he is a cruiser. Can he get another volley off? And he does. Well done. Hey, not him, Mutsu. Me. Aim for me. Skip this Pensacola. I'm trying to gun my engine as quick as I can to help him out. Oh, come on, can I? Wow. I bet you he's gonna get more damage. Yep, he did. And of course, the North Carolina does a lot of damage to my ship. Hey, but the New Max killed him. Problem solved, sir. And we killed the destroyer with a torpedo. Excellent. Figure out what that Fuso's doing, but he's not doing anything, so I'm just gonna shoot him and hit him. I think he's AFK. He left the match. Yeah, he has left the match. Whole team focused on Mutsu. There's an enemy Otago coming in. He's in torp range, but I'm not going to use my torpedoes. Turning, and then firing. And we killed him. And now I'm going to support our troops in the back against this full health Mugami and New Mexico. So I'm going to try to have my forces split in two. Alright, the Mugami's broadside. Aim a little high because he seems to be at this weird angle. There's that enemy Akatsuki. That is a nasty ship you don't want to be near. This is why. Enemy New Mexico went broadside. We did massive damage to that ship. And of course we're getting Citadel from New Mexico since I can't see him in the smoke. So I'm gonna blind fire torpedoes. Gotta be there somewhere. We hit him. There he is. And our secondaries are opening up on him. Hey, we got a torp hit. He's flooding, I think. Yep, he's flooding. He might not last longer. There he goes. So now the only thing is that Mugami and that Akazuki. And the Mugami is now hiding. Oh, he fired. That spots him. Now every ship is now pinning him. That volley should do it. Oh nope, too low, too low. Look good, but God, none of these guys can aim. There we go. And now every ship is going against that Akazuki.
Battle ends in 5 minutes.
Tell my team that capping A gives you big points. Most people will know that, but want to throw it out there because some people just keep forgetting. Okay, we got two ships capping the point. The Aoba and the Hipper are screening for that DD, but that DD's behind the island, guys. Turn your ship. Hipper, don't go away, go in. Have some cojones and hit the target. You know where it is now. At least the Aoba knows what he's doing. have some balls and go in. And he's like, I'm going. That's not you I was talking about. Alright, no big deal though. We already got what we needed. Okay, so we died, of course, but we did okay. 93,000 damage. Target hits. 2 kills. No citadels. But that's no surprise with this ship. We had 3 torpids that caused flooding. 11 secondaries. We almost took out that New Mexico, man, guys. That was pretty good hits. And we saved a pretty good amount of points there. And like I said, the problem with this thing is that armor. It cannot handle a lot of shells. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed that little video, and hopefully you'll get some knowledge of what, if you want to get it or not. I'm not recommending the ship. I'm sorry. But it needs a bump, a slight bit on the dispersion. It's too weak. I'd say if they reduce the dispersion to, let's say, God, what could I say? Maybe 10 meters? Just a slight bit. This ship would be decent. It's just the dispersion is too spread, and it's like firing a shotgun. And you're wanting the citadel, it's pray that your shell will hit the citadel line. Because sometimes it just goes over the ship, even at 6k away. It's that inaccurate. Well, like I said, I hope you guys enjoyed that video. I hope you guys see you in the next one. And as always, take care.